I hate Christmas. I hate it with the most malice intentions ever. As a matter of fact, the thought of Christmas makes my skin crawl. I wasn't like this before. I used to cherish the holiday tradition, but all of that's changed now. It all started a couple years back when I was 26 years old. It was the holidays, so Christmas was around the corner while festivities were in full effect. Hey, I'm on my way to pick you up.
I'm excited to go Christmas shopping!
Yeah, me too. Me and my girlfriend Emma had dated since high school, so the bond that we shared was something most couples couldn't fathom, to say the least. I decided to propose to Emma on Christmas. Figured I couldn't go wrong on such a monumental occasion. I remember it being a snowy evening when me and Emma went to the mall to do some holiday Christmas shopping. The mall was bombarded with more shoppers than usual as there was a holiday sale going on in almost every store. I remember being in need of a festive outfit for my parents' upcoming Christmas party as my wardrobe lacked the attire. I decided to check out the clothing store Forever 21 as I could see they had a wide variety of selection from first glance. I picked out an array of various Christmas sweaters and headed to the fitting room while my girlfriend waited outside for me. Oh yeah, fits way better than my dad's lame hand-me-downs. Hey babe, how does this look? I noticed my girlfriend Emma wasn't there. I figured she must have gone back into the store to look at more clothes. As I left the changing room, I noticed from the corner of my eye that Emma was outside the store waiting in a huge line for something. I end up purchasing one of the sweaters and began to approach Emma. Hey babe, why'd you leave me hanging in the fitting room?
I wanted to line up and take a picture with him.
Emma, this line is huge. I'll just dress up as Santa later and you can take a picture of me.
He's not Santa, though.
I looked towards the direction of where the lineup began and realized that there were two separate lineups. One lineup was for a professionally taken photo with the mall Santa. The other lineup was for a picture with a man dressed as the Grinch. We were unfortunately in the lineup for the Grinch, as Emma was a pretty big fan of the character. I personally found the whole ordeal bizarre, considering he didn't have any professional setup like how the mall Santa had. No platform, no chair, no professional photographer, no elf services, just him and the bench he sat on. I assumed he was one of those street performers that just dressed up for donations, except there was no tip jar or anything that would allow guests to donate in. Emma, this guy looks kinda sus. Can we just leave?
Please just relax, Henry. It'll only take a couple of minutes.
I decided to bite my tongue and proceed with Emma's request, as there was nothing I could have said that could convince her otherwise. As we got closer to the front of the lineup, I could visibly see the Grinch's eyes light up with exhilaration, almost like I brought a sense of enthusiasm into his day. I decided to be ballsy and lock eyes with him, just to express more of my alpha male side towards this weirdo. As the line gradually progressed, I realized that he wasn't making eye contact with me, he was looking at my girlfriend Emma. It was blatantly obvious he had an interest in my girlfriend due to the lack of attention he was giving others taking photos with him. What the hell is this guy's problem? Why is he checking out my girlfriend? We eventually reached the front of the line and approached the Grinch to take a three-way selfie with my cell phone.
Hey buddy, the girl gets a picture first.
Dude, that's my girlfriend.
I said, get behind the girl, kid.
Stupid green prick.
Another beautiful hoe.
What did you just call me?
I mean, ho ho ho, Merry Christmas. What's your name, little girl?
My name is Emma.
Ooh, what a beautiful name to match such a beautiful face. Why don't you come here and sit on Daddy's lap?
Dude, what the hell is your problem?
Back off, loser. She wants a picture with me, not you.
He's my boyfriend. Don't talk to him like that.
Sit on my lap and be a good girl, Emma, or else Santa won't give you any presents this year. I'm putting you on my naughty list, you little brat!
That's when we decided to head home. I remember dropping off my girlfriend at her place and then heading home to assist my parents in prepping for the Christmas party the following night. My parents were really old school and put a lot of effort into decorating their household, especially during festive holidays like this. Later that night, I remember making myself a glass of hot chocolate spiked with a little bit of my dad's whiskey. I sat by the fireplace and enjoyed the fire crackling ambience while casually sipping on my drink. Figured I couldn't go wrong with that on a warm Christmas Eve. I remember hearing my cell phone ringing throughout the night. I recall being so intoxicated I couldn't see nor hear anything distinctively. Everything was blurry. It felt virtually impossible to move any fiber of my body, almost like I was stuck in a subconscious state of sleep paralysis. I began to close my eyes and doze off again. A couple hours later, I recall a voice whispering my name.
Hey, Henry. Henry, wake up. Hello, wake up, little drunk. It's me, Santa.
I could vaguely see the outline of a man that looked like a Santa figure standing in front of me. Bear in mind, I was still in a groggy and incoherent state of mind, so making out the gentleman's minuscule facial features was almost an impossible endeavor to comprehend.
Hey, Henry, I brought you a Christmas present.
Dad, is that you?
Henry, listen. I want you to open up this Christmas gift first when you wake up. Do you understand me?
Yeah, Dad, sir.
I'm going to leave it right here in the middle of the Christmas tree, okay?
Okay.
Anyways, Merry Christmas, Henry.
Merry Christmas, Dad.
Shh. Time to go to sleep again, Henry.
A couple hours later, I get awoken by the light from the living room window illuminating on my face. I realized I had blacked out due to the spiked concoction I had whipped up the previous night. I check my cell phone and realize that I had about 10 missed calls and over 100 missed texts from Emma. I open the text messages, only to see the text reading,
"Hey, is that you? Are you inside my place? This isn't funny, Henry."
And so on and so forth. What I found more disturbing was the last batch of messages, which read,
"I knew you were going to propose all along.
Merry Christmas, Henry."
It just kept repeating, over and over again. I began calling Emma's cell phone and only got her voicemail. That's when I closed my eyes and began recollecting the imagery of what transpired last night. I could vaguely recall someone dressed as Santa and leaving a present underneath the Christmas tree. That's when I noticed a box that looked out of place from the rest of the presents. I took the box and opened it, only to discover a severed hand. The hand had a message on it which read, "Marry me."
Ha ha ha!